Let's say you're going for a hike and out of nowhere an attacker appears. You don't know Krav Maga and you're not a bear. So how are you going to protect yourself if things get ugly? Chemistry, in the form of pepper spray. Pepper spray is no joke. This stuff is designed to hurt, and it's so effective that a single blast can reportedly debilitate a person for upwards of an hour. Let's take a look at what's going on in this weaponized hot sauce that gives it its sting. The active ingredient in pepper spray is capsaicin, which comes from peppers. But how is pepper spray that intense? I can jam a jalapeno in an attacker's eye all I want, but it's not gonna do a whole lot. To go from this to this, chemists finally grind up a whole bunch of peppers from the capsicum family. Then they use ethanol to extract the capsaicin. Next, most of the ethanol is evaporated off, leaving behind a sticky, oily residue, more formally known as oleoresin capsicum. This residue is mixed with propylene glycol and water. The propylene glycol causes the capsaicin to form little droplets that mix throughout the water, making a capsaicin water emulsion. Think of it as an oil and vinegar salad dressing, except with smaller droplets designed to inflict pain. It's then packaged into a spray can with a propellant and boom, pepper spray. We have a video on how capsaicin works and why it triggers that burning sensation. Check it out here. Pepper spray is especially painful when it comes into contact with mucous membranes in our eyes, nose, and mouth. And just like with many other things, it's the dose that makes the poison. The more capsaicin you're exposed to, the more you'll feel the burn. And pepper spray can have 10 times the capsaicin concentration as an habanero seed, or more. Ouch. Once someone is pepper sprayed, the capsaicin immediately triggers distress signals to the brain, essentially saying, help. Your body forces your eyes shut, produces streams of tears and buckets of mucus, all to try and protect against more injury and flush the capsaicin away. At the same time, the capsaicin inflames the skin around your eyes. It also stimulates nerve endings in the throat and spasms of the larynx, making it hard to talk. The pain has been described as feeling like thousands of pieces of glass shooting into your eyes. Sounds fun. So now let's say you accidentally got pepper spraying yourself. Here's what you need to know. First, do not touch your face. You're just gonna spread the capsaicin around and make the pain worse. To get this stuff off, you're going to need something that's nonpolar, since capsaicin is nonpolar. You're thinking milk's the answer, aren't you? It's not. While milk does contain nonpolar fats that can dull the burn, dumping it in your eyes isn't the best idea since it's not sterile. What you really need is one of these. These solutions are sterile, and they contain a salt like magnesium hydroxide, which cause the capsaicin molecules to be released from their emulsified prison and make them easier to rinse off. Just make sure not to grab a mint-flavored antacid. Menthol can make the pain worse. Yep, science shows mint-sprinkled hot wings might be a fusion food too far. Ideally, you'd then flush your eyes out for at least 15 minutes at a wash station, but chances are if you've been pepper sprayed, you're not gonna have one of those right next to you. So just use as much water after the antacid as you can. Now that you've flushed out your eyes, be sure to thoroughly wash your hands with a mild soap like liquid dish detergent. After all that, you don't want to accidentally recontaminate your eyes with any residual capsaicin from the pepper spray. But we hate to break it to you. One study suggests that depending on your own physiology, the best way to get rid of the pain is just to wait it out. Once the pain subsides and you can see again, consider seeing your way to a doctor, just to make sure everything's okay. We hope you never have to use it, but when worse comes to worse, the chemistry packed into that little canister can give you enough time to get out of a dangerous situation and live to learn about chemistry another day. Be sure to check out our video on how capsaicin works and make sure to hit that thumbs up on your way out. We'll see you next week.